Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage the Orange County Children's Theater's youngest knights and princesses, otherwise known as the Telegrammers.
Handsome prince with a gloomy face.
For he did not have a
sweet thing, delicate and dainty as a dragonfly's wing. You can recognize a lady by her elegant air.
But a genuine princess
is exceedingly rare. On a stormy night, to the castle door came the lass the prince had been waiting for.
I'm a princess, love,
quoth she. But the queen was cool and remained aloof, and she said,
perhaps, but we'll need some proof. I'll prepare a test and see. I will test her thus,
the old queen said.
I'll put 20 down to matches upon her bed, and beneath those 20 mattresses I will place a tiny pea. If the pea disturbs her slumber, then a true princess is she.
Now the bed was soft and extremely tall, but the dainty lass didn't sleep at all, and she told them so next day. Said the queen,
my dear, if you felt that peas any proof enough of your royalty, let a wedding music play.
And the people shouted quietly,
hooray!
For a princess is a delicate thing, delicate and dainty as a dragonfly's wing. You can recognize a lady by her elegant hair.
But a genuine princess
is exceedingly rare. Reason that I was there. It was a small kingdom ruled over by a talkative queen and a meek king. The princess in the true story was not the only girl put to the test. Actually, she was one of 13 girls who came to the castle hoping to wed the prince, but who, for one reason or another, were found to be unsuitable.
As a matter of fact, the day I arrived, they were testing princess number 12. A curious quiz was in progress.
Are you ready for the next question?
I guess so.
Well then, name three kings. Is that clear?
Yes. Would you repeat the question, please?
Name three kings.
May I take the third king first? Mm-hmm. Well then, three kings are...
Is this a trial?
No, it's the royalty test to find out if she's a true princess.
One, King John. Two, King Arthur.
Does it matter if she's a true princess?
Oh, yes. If she's a true princess, then we can all get married. And King Alfred?
That's absolutely correct!
Can I marry Alfred, please?
No!
Sweetheart,
there's still one more question. This test isn't gonna be fair.
It's the law that isn't fair.
Law?
The marriage law. Throughout the land, no one may wed till dauntless to the altar's led.
Dauntless?
The prince. Until he gets married, none of us can.
You have now reached the seventh plateau, and here is your final question. It is divided into four parts and concerns of a famous man, often referred to as the Knights of the Red Cross. One, what's his name? Two, what beast did he slay? Three, how many rows of teeth did the beast have, and what kind?
2, the dragon. 3, 12 rows of teeth, and they were iron. And would you repeat the question, please?
The middle name, the daughter-in-law of the best friend of the blacksmith who forged the sword that killed the beast.
The middle name?
The middle name.
The daughter-in-law?
In-law. You have 30 seconds.
Oh, pass, please, pass!
Do you speak, my lady?
No, I just...
20 seconds!
Oh!
I wish her success. She's a pretty little thing.
10 seconds!
Oh!
I'm terribly sorry.
Oh!
Your time's up.
Too bad, my dear, too bad. You do show certain aptitude, but as for the true brilliance of royalty, well, I'm afraid not. Remember, blood will tell, and yours didn't tell us quite enough. However, to show that there are no hard feelings, we have a nice consolation prize for you.
Oh, ugh.
So, goodbye, good luck, and get out! Dauntless, oh, Dauntless, darling, stop pouting. Now come along, Dauntless, it's nearly time for your cocoa.
Oh, I liked her.
So did I.
Why must every princess get the bird?
It's just absurd.
I never heard a test so difficult to pass.
Alas, alas, is what I lack, alas. Alas, alack,
throughout the land, no one may wed till dawn, who shares his marriage bed.
Busy.
Oh, well, the latest princess was a failure.
No.
Yes.
Bad luck, but don't despair, for we have plenty of time. If I don't find a new princess in the next few months, then I don't deserve to wear my spurs.
Darling!
Yes, Larkin.
Do you remember the Royal Joust on Sunday when you won those spurs?
Of course I do.
When everyone called you Sir Harry, the fairest and bravest knight in all the land, everyone agreed that you had a bright future ahead of you, that you might someday become Lord Chamberlain or ever Prime Minister?
Well, I don't know about Prime Minister.
Do you remember the picnic we all had later on the greensward with the lovely gold pheasant?
Yes.
And you and I wandered away from the others to climb the hill and watch the sun go down?
Yes.
And there was a lark singing in the trees. And you said you'd remember that moment forever because the lark song reminded you of my name.
Yes.
And then we watched the sun go down.
Yes, Larkin, yes.
Well, I'm going to have a baby. So you see, a Princess Bonatlas must be found, and soon, or I shall have to go away somewhere. Oh, darling, I'm so worried. This could ruin you, and you'd never be Prime Minister or anything. Just say the word, and I will go somewhere where they will never find me. Just say the word.
No, you'll stay here. Why should we both suffer all of our lives just because you had a moment of weakness?
Oh, Harry.
Everything's gonna be all right. None of us are perfect.
Thank you, Harry.
It won't be long, it won't be long, it won't, because it can't be long before our dreams come true. Because, you know, I don't belong, and furthermore, I shan't belong to anyone but you. In a little while, just a little while, you and I will be 1, 2, 3, 4. In a little while, I will see her smile on the face of our son to be forever hand in glove. Is the way I have it planned, but we'll only stay in love if the glove contains your hand.
In a velvet gown, I'll be coming down.
How long have you been, my love?
November.
November.
My time is at a premium, and soon the world will see me. I'm eternal bride to be. I know I mustn't worry, Harry. Still, I wish you'd hurry, Harry. Harry, marry me.
In a little while, just a little while, I will be 1, 2, 3, 4. In a little while, I will see your smile on the face of my son to be forever hand in glove. Is the way I have it planned, but we'll only stay in love if the glove contains your hand. I can see it all down to every small detail, and I'd hope you'd look around until you found the castle in the neighborhood for sale.
Come along, darling, don't dawdle. Dauntless, stop dragging your feet and don't squint. I told you not to stare at the sun.
Yes, Mama.
Once I have told you 100,000 times, I will not have you playing these foolish games and running around in the halls. It just isn't dignified. If we're not going to set a proper example for the rest of the court, I'd like to know who will. I mean, what is the point of being a ruler if one isn't going to behave as a ruler should?
Mama?
Now what?
When am I going to get my princess?
Oh, Douglas, I don't want to discuss that right now. It's time for your cocoa.
But sometimes I feel like, you know, I'm gonna get married.
Don't want you to get married! Oh, Dauntless, don't want you to get married! Dauntless, don't you trust me? times have I said to you, I want you to get buried? Only this morning I was saying to your father, I said, Mutimus, I want that boy to get married. But just as if normal for a boy that age to stay single, and after all, he is the prince. Don't forget he's next in line for the throne, and we're not exactly the oldest people in the world, but we're not going to live forever. And I know I'd feel much better, much easier, and much more relaxed in my mind if that boy were married, settled, and set. And that is absolutely verbatim exactly what I said to your father this morning. Of course, he didn't say anything. He never does, but you know your father just as well as I do, and I don't have to tell you how impossible he is. But if he makes me miserable and makes me suffer, I just have to put up with it, and I will not allow it to affect my child's behavior towards him or me. He may be a mean, stupid, dreadful, selfish, rotten man, but he's your father, and I want you to respect him. There is only one person who really cares about you and your health and your happiness and your future. And that's exactly what I'm talking about here. Your future. And let me make myself absolutely clear. I want you to get married, but I don't want you to marry just anybody. After all, marriage is a lifetime partnership, and I wouldn't want to see my sweet, beautiful baby boy make the same mistake I did. And wind up miserable the way I did. She has to be someone suitable. Someone who's good enough and sweet enough and smart enough for my good, nice, sweet, smart, beautiful baby boy. And she has to be a princess. That is absolutely one thing I insist upon. A true, genuine, bona fide princess just as I was. Oh, but that's what you want, isn't it? Someone like me? Oh, of course you do. Oh, God, if I were only 20 years younger, what the... Remember this, you must trust me.
Your Majesty, Your Highness.
Hello, Harry.
Don't interrupt.
Well, Sir Harry would like to speak to you, Madam.
Madam, I'd like to request a perilous labor. I wish to search for a true princess, one of the royal blood, one that will be able to please both Dauntless and Your Majesty.
No.
Mama!
No, no, no! We've been through all of the eligible girls in the neighboring kingdoms, and there are none left. We simply have to wait till their little sisters grow up, and that'll take years.
But madam, I have planned to head over the mountains.
Over the mountains?
Across the Badlands.
Across the Badlands?
And into the swamp where the beautiful marsh lily grows.
Into the marsh? Are you out of your mind?
Let him go, Mama, let him go.
But you'll find nothing there except for frogs and tadpoles and things.
But Mama.
Do you know what the weather is like?
Yes, Mama.
Do you know how damp and foggy and humid and oppressive?
Mama, no, Mama, please, for me.
Oh, all right, go ahead. It's your signing.
Hooray.
Now, come on, Dauntless, you missed your cocoa.
Have good luck, Harry.
Don't worry, little Arkin. I'll bring a prince back, a princess that will be able to pass the queen's test.
Oh, I believe you.
And I shan't be away long.
Just fly as fast as you can, my love. We shall be waiting for you.
We?
Oui. Well, you know. And wear this.
Next to my heart.
In a little while, just a little while, you and I will be 1, 2, 3, 4.
In a little while, I will see your smile on the face of my son to be forever. And in love is the way I have it planned, but we'll only stay. A velvet gown will be coming down the aisle, and it's bound to seem as though the waiting's only been a little, in a little while.
Sir Harry's perilous journey took 3 weeks. And Lady Larkin had all but given up hope that he would find a true princess.
Then, one sunny morning in mid-April, when the crocuses were just beginning to dot the meadows.
A 1, a 2, a 1, 2!
Not now, not now! Off,
two,
off, off!
Sorry!
lookout in the north round tower spied two distant figures approaching at full gallop. The alarm was spread. Sir Harry is back! Sir Harry is back with the princess!
Now let's see. How does this part go into the old story?
Musicians!
Musicians, we're here! On stormy night,
the castle door came the last the prince had been waiting for.
That, of course, is utterly untrue.
It didn't snow that night at all. In fact, it wasn't even night.
But the princess looked as though she'd come in from a storm.
Actually, I swam them all. But never mind all that if I stand right. Here, there's a nice draft. I'll be dry in no time.
Look, Mama, she's all wet.
You swam on the boat. We tried to stop her, but she wouldn't wait for the drawbridge. You swam on the boat.
She said her mission would arrive as soon as possible.
We had to pull out the rope.
You swam the boat. All right. I was a little anxious. My friend, Sir Harry. He's still down there. He said you had an opening for a princess. Any princess. And I figured, barely bird. Anyway, here I am. Who's the lucky man? Hey, naughty, naughty.
Hey, naughty, 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 go.
Hey, naughty, naughty, is it you?
Hey, naughty, 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 too.
Hey, naughty, naughty, is it you? Or you, or you, or you, or.
Naughty, 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 naughty.
No, no, no.
Someone's being bashful. No way to be not with me. Can't you see that I am just as embarrassed as you, and I can understand your point of view. I've always been shy. I confess it, I'm shy.
Can't you guess that this confident air is a mask that I wear, 'cause I'm shy. And you may be sure, way down deep, I'm demure. Though some people I know might deny it, at bottom I'm quiet and pure. I'm aware that it's wrong to be meek as I am. My chances may pass me, but I pretend to be strong. But as weak as I am, all I can do is try. God knows I try. Frightened and shy, and despite the impression I give, I confess that I'm living a lie, because I'm actually terribly, terribly, and horribly shy. Quite often a lady's not as hard to please as she seems. Quite often she'll settle for something less than the man of her dreams. I'm going fishing for a mate.
She's going fishing for a mate.
I'm gonna look in every brook.
She's gonna look in every brook.
But how much longer must I wait?
With bated breath and hope.
Oh,
to ask it yourself.
You never say anything else except...
Do you mean to ask me to believe that you are a true princess of the royal blood and you have the nerve and the gall and the presumption to apply for my son's hand in marriage? Well, you are laying under a very unfortunate misapprehension, my dear. My son will not be marrying any moat swimmer.
Mama, may I say something?
No, not while I have a breath in my body, and by God, I haven't been well. Not well at all. I give these shooting pains all in through here, and don't try to tell me it's the vapors. I know what the vapors are. I've had the vapors.
Are you new here? Watch closely. I take a perfectly plain piece of parchment with no cuts, folds, creases, or concealed pockets.
It's a nut house!
Please don't leave! Don't leave us!
Oh, no, please don't go.
So, you're the one, I guess.
Sure, I'm Dauntless the Drow.
Well, glad to have met you.
No, please. I like you. Everybody likes you. Well, almost everybody.
Dauntless, I'd like to stay here, but I wouldn't want to come between you and your mother.
Get out.
So I'll just face the facts, cut my losses, and head back to the swamps.
But I really like you.
You do? Why?
You swam the moat.
Dauntless, I know I swam the moat, but that's not the real me. I'm not like that. Actually, I'm Shaw!
Oh, again.
I have the honor. I have the honor to announce the arrival of Royal Highness Princess Winifred.
You're a little late. She's been here and gone.
Gone?
Yes, she's swimming home right now, and that, Sir Harry, is no princess.
But she is your majesty.
What?
That one, yes.
On my honor as knight, I swear she is. I have her papers right here. Princess Winifred, princess of Igpongfield, guardian of the Midgard Serpent, and warden of the Ragnarok Marshal. Her family inscription reads, to the Seedy Malice at Contra, Dantiora Ita.
What does that mean?
Roughly it means, if at first you don't succeed...
Never mind.
You see, she is a princess.
She looks like a princess.
I know she's a princess.
She must be a princess. At least a test,
Your Majesty. At least a test, Mama, for me.
Oh, all right. We'll test her. The wizard and I will put on our thinking caps and come up with a nice, fair test, just as we always do. And I'll prove to you that girl can simply not be a princess.
Grab her by the leg.
This is her leg.
That's not my leg.
You gotta see her swim, Mama. She's wonderful.
Yes, isn't she?
That's what she swam the moat.
It's cold.
Twice.
Oh, yes, I don't need any help.
Can I marry her now? Can I, please?
Marry her? Of course not. When you marry him, you marry. You will marry a real princess, not a crude one. We'll test her for sensitivity. Oh, you see? She'll have her test, and she'll fail. Just like all the others, fair and square.
Failed what?
The royalty test.
Every princess learned from my hand must pass a test to prove she's a real princess.
What kind of test?
It's always highly secret.
Well, we'll worry about that later. Right now, I better get out of these wet clothes.
Would you like me to show you the Hall of Ancestors on the way to your room?
Sure.
You're awfully nice.
You're nicer.
And you're good looking, too.
You're better looking and nicer, too.
This is my Aunt Hilda. She's the jokester in the family.
What a joker!
You're a really good swimmer.
Oh, Your Majesty! Sir Harry is back. Yes, he is, and he's for us a sweet princess. Have you seen her?
Well, neither have I, but I'm sure she's as delicate as an orange blossom, and I'm to be her lady-in-waiting.
Sir Harry arranged it. Isn't he thoughtful? He arranges everything.
Expect to meet a bonus lady. Two syllables. First syllable.
Bird?
Bird. Some kind of bird. Auk. Bluebird. Catbird. Dove. Eagle. Finch. Grouse. Hawk. Ibis. Jay. Kiwi. Lark.
Lark!
Oh, Lady Larkin.
And a knight.
Which knight?
Sir Harry.
Dust. Sounds like dust.
Must?
Must what?
You're going to start all over, right?
Trouble.
What kind of trouble?
Big trouble.
How many syllables?
She's going to have a baby! Does anyone else know? Sir Harry.
Of course. But does anyone else know besides Sir Harry?
Don't worry. We can keep a secret. The question is, can you?
Well, we know you can't talk, but you managed to communicate.
We have only three voices among us, and yet there's a fourth voice, a voice in disguise. You will hear not a trio, instead a quartet, if you listen with both of your eyes. Kindly, with both of your eyes. A unique and remarkable blend.
When we raise our four voices on high, we're in perfect accord from beginning to the king and the minstrels and I. Yet if one of our quartet should ever depart, then the others would languish and die. We're like four different people with only one, the king and the jester and I.
Sing hey, nonny, nonny, hey, nonny, nonny, hi, diddle, diddle, strike up a tune on the...
Oh, the bishop declares our behavior is crude, as he piously looks to the sky.
Cause when we go in swimming, we always go, the king and the jester,
the king and the minstrels.
Wine from the grapes that he grows. 20 barrels were lost last July. Where they went is a secret that nobody.
Oh, the cook claims she's missing one chocolate cream roll and a fish that was ready to fry. Guess who's dining on pastry and filet up?
Hey, naughty, naughty, needle and thimble,
crush us and flash on the... It's been said that her king claims his marbles are loose,
but the queen is much worse on the sly.
Well, what's good for the gander is good for the... Say the king and the jester,
the king and the minstrels.
Looks fair. And
sounds fair and seems fair. But is it fair? When you came up with the idea for sensitivity, I could have applauded you right out loud, but exactly what?
Table manners?
No, not good enough. Sensitivity, sensitivity, I'm just loaded with that. In this one word is the epitome of the aristocrat. Sensitive soul and sensitive stomach, sensitive hands and feet.
This is a blessing,
also the curse of being the true elite. Common people don't know what exquisite agony is suffered by gentle people like me. Just get your hands off me! Think of a tricky test for that wretched moat swimming princess.
Madam, may I suggest?
Maybe we ought to... Don't take all night, I'm not well, I need my rest. Not that I'd ever sleep on that lumpy mattress, oh God, my back! Sensitivity, bane of royalty, that bed a torture rack. Oh, I hate to sound grumpy, but my nerves are so jumpy. I am sure I could feel any lump, even if it were under the mattress and small as a pea. That's the answer! Under the mattress, we'll test her tonight. One tiny pea beneath one thick downy mattress. God, you're bright.
I know.
Any genuine princess would feel it. If she doesn't, she's through. Get the tiniest pea in order. One mattress? No, make it two.
Why not five?
10, I think, would be plenty. Better still, make it 20. And to play it safe in the event, even that's not enough to ensure that she sleeps. We'll give her a soothing sedative, won't we? You can whip up a drink. Something stunning. Oh, but you're devilish. I love the way you think. She's insensitive, so insensitive. She'll fall asleep, no doubt. God, but you're clever, brilliant, a genius. You are divine. Get out.
Heartless, he really means it.
Alas, madam, the king is mute, or he would speak for himself. He is still under a curse cast long ago by a witch before Prince Dauntless was born. The curse says King Mutimus will not talk until the mouse devours the hawk.
Until the mouse devours the hawk? Well, can't you get a big mouse and a little hawk and then
well,
you just
we tried that, but the mouse got scared and ran away, and the hawk bit Daddy.
Well, just let me get this test under my belt and we'll figure something out. Don't you worry. It certainly has been a pleasure meeting His Majesty. A short while ago, I had the pleasure of meeting Her Majesty. Now that was a nice man.
Your Majesty, I think you ought to have that little talk.
About what?
Your father feels that he's been neglecting his duty, and now that you're old enough to get married, he thinks you ought to have that little talk. You know, man to man.
Oh! Oh, about things? Now?
Your father feels that it would be better to wait until later. There are a few things he would like to look up first.
I certainly do like almost both your parents, Dauntless.
Well, we want you to feel at home here. And we know it's a lot different than what you're used to.
It is a little hard making the adjustment to dry land.
Yeah.
You must feel like a fish out of water.
Oui, comme un petit poisson au dehors. As a matter of fact, I do. You see, where I come from, we don't have any dry land. Some poor people do, but all the nobility live right in the swamps with their servants and their pets.
Oh, do you have pets?
Lots.
Dogs?
Frogs.
I come from the land of the foggy, foggy dew. Ooh, 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 ooh.
Them all, and the ones I can't use, I'll send back.
Are you sure we can't help?
Farewell, Your Highness. Ladies.
You'll see that it's all taken care of.
Thanks. It's already been taken care of.
I see that you've met my dear Lady Larkin.
This is the little Larkin girl?
The very same one.
Why, Harry, she's beautiful and a bundle of energy. Now, if you'll excuse me. I have to return these dresses to the fourth floor. Oh, I've never been so humiliated in my life.
What's wrong?
I thought she was a chambermaid.
What?
A chambermaid.
Larkin, how could you? How could you mistake a princess for a chambermaid?
How could I? How could you mistake that chambermaid for a princess?
Don't say such a thing just because you made a stupid mistake.
I made a mistake? Don't you dare try and blame this on me.
I do blame it on you. Wherever she was a true princess, and that's more than I can say about some people around here.
I hate you!
I hate you too!
Get out!
I'm leaving.
Goodbye!
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 Oh, make sure to make a potion of some of that good, heavy incense. And bring that hypnotic mirror, too. Oh, wait. The most important thing is that she's tired out first. We'll have an official ball tonight. We'll make what's-her-name dance till she drops. Now, what can we do? Oh! Do you know the Saracen Brawl? No! No! Not hard enough. I have it. We can do that new dance, the Spanish Panic. Have you heard of it? Well, it's all the rage in Venice. Everyone, listen up. We're to have an official ball tonight, and everyone is to attend. We're going to do that new dance, the Spanish Panic, so you might as well learn it right now. All right, so the basic steps are flip your skirt, open, close, right, right, right. Get it? Okay, again, flip your skirt, open, close, right, right, wrong! Does anybody know the Spanish Panic?
Yes, Your Majesty.
Oh, why, thank heavens somebody's up to date around here. Why don't we all watch while Sir Harold and Lady Beatrice demonstrate?
Oh,
Beatrice. Now, was that so hard? Suppose you all try it. Take partners, prepare, eh? Don't you just love it? Those things make you want to fly away!
Oh, wait, my...
tonight's dancing and tell the jester I want her to perform. Not that I'll be able to enjoy any of it with all the pain in my back and the strange nagging pain in my jaw. Oh God, nobody will ever know what I suffer.
What's she jabbering about? The queen's gonna make us do something.
What?
Exercise. Someone's coming.
Who is it?
I don't know. My lady, is there something wrong?
No.
Well, we're glad of that anyway.
I was just sitting in my room, sewing, and it got a little stuffy, so I decided to come out here and get some air.
I see you were planning to camp out for a while.
Oh, you don't know, you just don't know! How could you have any idea what can happen to the relationship between a man and a woman? I'm leaving!
You're leaving?
I'm leaving the service of the queen forever!
That's a pretty big step to take all alone.
Well, I have no choice.
You're leaving forever?
Yes.
You'll need help.
Who would help me?
I, my lady.
You want to take care of the lady, Larkin? Well, who's going to take care of you?
Chivalry demands we protect a damsel in distress.
If you say so, Your Majesty.
But she'll have to travel light, the way a man does.
We'll steal one of Prince Dauntless's suits. You can wait in your room. We'll take these out of sight.
No, I can go alone. I don't need help from anyone.
Over the wall?
I can go alone.
Well, you'll be all right. Once you get past the water rats.
Rats?
Oh, yes. They live on the edges of the stagnant pools near the quicksand.
Quicksand?
Beyond the wall. But you must climb.
Climb!
I'm covered in feet. I'm covered in slime.
Slime!
And infested with spiders.
Spiders! Spiders! Snakes!
Snakes!
On your side!
Well, they won't hurt you, unless, of course, you insist on leaving alone.
I was going to, but if I'd known it was so terrible out there, I wouldn't have thought!
Then you think a second thought and come with me. I know all the secret ways to get us free.
Over the hills into the open sea!
And where?
It's April, isn't it?
April?
Normandy is fine and fair. So Normandy is where we'll go.
I can show you a beach where the beach blossom blows.
knows a man who knows a ghost.
In a friendly place, with rows of windows facing the sea.
This time of year, the air I hear is rare and clear and poor. In mustard flowers gold on as the sun.
Where a wondrous thing can happen when an April day is done. This moment after twilight, when the sky is suddenly green, and the world stands hush and waiting for the first white stars to convene. When you see that emerald sky, you'll know the reason why.
There's not another place I'd rather be.
Keep your Eldorado
and say no to Burgundy. Come fly
with me. Come try those wings.
Come swift
for me has things to do.
Is there truly a beach where the peach blossom falls? Are you sure you
Thank you.
Feeling a little weary, dear.
No, let's do it again.
Oh, out of my way.
Maybe you could give me a clue.
Clue?
I know. Hide and seek, but what sort of test does she usually give?
Well, with Mama, it could be almost anything.
Like what?
It could be spelling.
Oh!
Oh, it could be dancing. It could be history.
Oh!
But sometimes it's a test of strength and endurance.
Uh-huh.
For instance, one of the girls had to lift up this weight. She couldn't. I can't even lift it. But I know you'll pass, you don't have to worry.
Do you want me to pass? I'll pass.
I think you're wonderful.
By the way, I don't think I ever told you. My full name is Winifred the Wogeygon. Winifred's too formal. You can call me by my nickname.
Winnie?
Fred!
Fred, what a beautiful name. So straight, so strong, so you. I like you, Fred. I like you.
You're just saying those words to be kind.
No, I mean it. I love you, Fred.
He's out of his medieval mind.
I'm perfectly sane and sound. I've never felt better in my life. Everybody, 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 come and meet my incipient wife. Yeah! Fred, my reasons must be clear. When she shows you all how strong she is, you'll stand right up and cheer. I'm in love with a girl named Fred. She drinks just like the Lord. So come sing your merry drinking song and let the wine be poured. I'm in love with a girl named Fred. She sings just like a bird. You'll be left completely speechless when her gentle voice is heard.
Fill the boat to overflowing, raise the goblet high. With an F and an R, an E and a D, an F, R, E, and Fred. Yeah!
I'm in love with a girl named Fred. She wrestles like a Greek. You will clap your hands in wonder at her fabulous technique. Dances with such grace, you are bound to sing her praises till you're purple in the face.
Bravo, 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 bravo. Oh. Fill the boat to overflowing, raise the goblet high.
I'm in love with a girl named Fred. She's musical to boot. She will set your feet a tapping when she plays up on her lute.
Bravo, bravo, bravissimo, bravo, bravissimo.
Please don't hurt me.
Fill the boat to overflowing, raise the goblet high.
With an F and an R, E and a D and an F, R, E, Fred. Yeah.
I'm in love with a girl named Fred, a clever clownish wit. When she does her funny dance, I'm on your side to shift your split.
Bravo, 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 bravo,
bravo, I'm in love with a girl.
He's in love with a girl named
F-R-E-D.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back to the stage your favorite cast members, the Telegrammers.
With directors Patrick Sales, Bethany Price, Ashley Turnbaugh, and Kayla Keyrose. Auditions for our next show, Big Fish, are also coming up. You can find information online at occt.org or in the lobby during our 15-minute intermission.
I want the truth. What is all this noise about? Every time I turn my back, there's something outrageous going on in the corridors. Now, what is going on here? What are you up to? What? Well, there's something going on around here. What's under the mattress? It's a dead body! Pull that away! What is the meaning of this? Explain yourself!
It was just a joke, Your Majesty. This boy and I, go outside and wait for me. Lancelot.
Lancelot, wait. Lady Larkin?
Please, Your Majesty. What?
Why are you in this ridiculous getup?
Your Majesty.
Silence. And why weren't you at the ball tonight?
Your Majesty.
Shut up. And why are you with this man?
Please,
well,
Your Majesty.
Speak up. You were running away, weren't you? You were running away!
Larkin!
Oh! Croissant! Is this the thanks I get for treating you as one of my own daughters? Please imagine one of my girls running off with a musician!
Your Majesty, I'll tell you the truth. The Lady Larkin is innocent. We forced her to leave against her will.
That's not true!
Why, you love?
Just a moment!
Larkin, what are you doing with that man?
What are you doing with that woman?
Just a moment!
You go to your room.
Don't tell me what to do, you liberty!
Quiet! Lady Larkin, need I still remind you that you are one of my ladies-in-waiting? Get upstairs where you belong and prepare what's-her-name for bed.
Please
do! As I say. And as for you, Sir Harry, my bravest and most chivalric knight in all of my... And you relax. Sir Harry, I want these minstrels banished from my kingdom, and I want them out by daybreak. Go to bed. I don't want you groping around in the dark all night. Oh, God. And as for the rest of you, there's a little girl upstairs who is dog tired.
Oh, no. She said she was going to study for her test.
Oh. All right. Let her study. But when she is ready for bed, I want quiet. And I'm going to get quiet. I have to scream the palace down.
Quiet!
Quiet, quiet, quiet. The queen insists on quiet. She's ordered 20 mattresses, the softest and the best. And she's ordered execution if we dare disturb the rest of her very special guest. She's ordered quiet, quiet, quiet.
Some.
Some. S-U-M. Some.
Summer.
Summer. S-U-M. E-R. Summer.
Correct. Well, if Mama tests you in literature spelling, you're sure to pass. Now that just leaves... Oh, history.
History? That takes in quite a bit, but let's give it a whirl.
The first chapter is called The Bravery of Prince Waldir.
Waldir?
Young Waldir wishing to slay the dragon Fafnir.
Who?
Wishing to slay the dragon Fafnir.
Oh, yeah! Fafnir. That one.
Takes the sword Minning.
Minning.
Disguises the west wind. He goes into the forest and surprises Fafnir in his lair and slays him. Whereupon he's unable to understand the speech of Bird. Meanwhile, Waldir's father, Albert, who's also disguised as the sacred goat, tells him that the spirit of Gunther...
Oh, yeah! Gunther! But I thought that Gunther was the goat that used magic... Is you ready for a page boy?
No.
Well,
suit just like that.
I was running away. I'm in disguise.
Well, you must be tired. Dauntless, pull up a chair.
Oh, no, but the queen has ordered me to help.
Fine, the queen has ordered. Just sit.
But your highness is...
Just sit down.
Now, what's all this about? Maybe I should just go out on that parapet and stand there and catch a cold and die. That'll show him.
Show him what?
He'll be sorry.
He'll be sorry.
Horrible Harry!
You mean big, nice Harry?
Wait a minute. What did you do to him?
What did I do to him?
Well, you must have done something. You're talking the way I did once. I was afraid to go home because I'd given my brother a bloody lip. It was an accident?
We had a little disagreement.
So you decided to run away?
He said some perfectly horrible things to me.
In that case, I guess you were right. I guess just about the only thing you can do is pack up and get out. Unless, of course, you go to him and say you're sorry. Listen, that Harry's a wonderful boy and he really cares about you. I'd be on the road for 2 weeks and he never laid a finger on this. Now, go get me something pretty that shows you're a girl and patch things up with him. And Larkin, try to act a little helpless. Men don't like girls that are too strong.
I do.
You. If it's a girl, I'm gonna name her Fred.
And if it's a boy.
Dauntless, leave the history book. You better go to bed.
I'm sure you're gonna pass Mama's test tomorrow. At least I think. But if you don't, I'll understand.
And so the young Prince Waldir, having slain the dragon Fafnir, using the sword Minning, rescued the Princess Frigga. And together they mounted his horse Trigga, where they rode to the castle Gundrabar and were married and lived happily ever after. Well, I'm so glad. Happily, happily, happily ever after. The couple is happily leaving the chapel eternally tied. As the curtain descends, there is nothing but loving and laughter. When the fairy tale ends, the heavens always a bride. Now the girl of the cinders did the wash and the walls and the winders. Up she landed a prince, he was brawny and blue-eyed and blonde. Still, I honestly doubt that she could ever have done it without that crazy lady with a wand, Cinderella, outside her. I have no one but me, fairy godmother, 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 where can you be? I haven't got a fairy godmother. I haven't even got a godmother. I've got a mother, a plain, ordinary. They tell us that the queen was exalted and jealous when the mirror declared that Snow White was the fairest of all. She was dumped on the border, but was saved by Sunette, adored her. Oh, I grant you, they were small, but there were seven of them, practically a regiment. I'm alone in the night by myself, not a dwarf, not an elf, not a goblin in sight. That girl had seven little determined men working day and night for her. The queen had a poisoned apple, but even still, they all lived happily, happily, happily ever after. A magical kiss counteracted the apple eventually. Though I know I'm not clever, I'll do what they tell me I have to. Happily ever after to happen to me. Rapunzel had platinum dresses.
kept in a tower for years by all we could hold with. Then one night in despair down, she scrambled by letting her hair down. That's what I call quite a switch. Wonder, no, it'll never hold. I'll be finished before I begin. And besides, I want to get out. I want to get in. I want some happily, happily, happily ever after. I want to walk happily, leaving the chapel eternally dead. For I know that I'll never be happily ever after. Till after.
Kingdom against your will, and that's a serious offense.
They didn't do it. It was a frame-up.
You got it all wrong.
They were protecting the Lady Larkin, and you stay out of this, Your Majesty.
Sir Harry, we can't leave yet. There's someone we must see first.
Who?
The wizard. I want your permission to speak to the wizard.
No, permission denied.
Sir Harry, you're a...
fathead!
Yes, you are. They were trying to help. We're all trying to help.
How could you help?
By finding out what the test is from the wizard.
That's cheating.
Don't you understand? This is for you.
Let us speak to the wizard.
No. If anyone should go and defy the wizard's magic, I should.
You must stand guard. This is my job. No, you might get hurt. You can't come, and that's final.
The king mustn't come with us.
I'll get rid of him. Your Majesty, Prince Douglas is ready now. He ought to have that little talk with you.
Oh, well, some other time.
Your father would like to have that little talk with you. It's very important.
It is?
Yes, and it cannot be put off. Do your duty, sire.
Well, what do you want to talk about, Pop? What is it? Stop. Look. Listen. Oh, boy! Flower. Girl. Okay, flower. Boy, flower, girl, flower. Oh, tell me more. I want to know about what getting married is for. Oh, seed, yeah. Fall from girl flower, and by, oh baby, flower, grow. Ah, but why? Oh, tell me why. Oh, father, tell me, father, don't be shy. Boy flower, girl flower, love each other. Boy, flower, father. Girl, flower, her mother. Yes, but how? It's very interesting, but how? Oh, tell me now. Bee. From boy, flower. Boy, flower, dust. Gets on bee. Bee flies to girl flower. Dust touches girl flower. Oh, I see. No, I don't see. It's very interesting, but still not clear to me. Oh, woman is like girl flower. man is like bee, and like boy flower. Oh man, that's me. Oh, tell me more.
I want to know about what getting married is for.
Carrie, sounds like Carrie. Oh, Mary. Winifred and White love each other. A night. Oh, and then one night.
Yes, one night. It's very interesting what happens in the night.
What happens?
Oh, Father, tell me, please. Shall I go and pick some flowers? Shall I go and catch some bees?
Oh, Princess Winifred, okay. And I will get married. And then one night.
Stork?
The stork will come and bring us a baby. Oh, Papa! Mama told me about the stork years ago.
No, wait a minute, Papa. Flower, seed, man, woman, bee, baby, small. It isn't the stork at all. Oh, life is grand. It's very interesting. I think I understand. I think I know. It's very interesting. Thank you, Father. And Father, I love you so.
At Glossombury in 92.
What a show.
What a triumph. You took 7 curtain calls.
8.
Do you happen to remember a little boy in the second row who stood up and yelled, "Bravo!" that night?
Yes.
I was that boy.
I can't believe it. Of course. Now, we're in show business, too.
And ma'am, if it's any interest to you, it was your inspiration that brought this about.
You must belong to the guild! Local Camelot 714! To think someone remembers those days.
I just wanted to tell you what that performance meant to me, Cardamon. Well, we'd better be going now.
Wait, here, for you.
Thank you.
Stay, please. No, the queen would not like her if she were still around. Never mind her.
Get out of the fire.
Anyway, you're probably busy with the test tomorrow. No, that's all taken care of.
Well, I don't suppose you could tell an old guild partner what the test is about.
Well, I'm sort of under oath.
I understand. Well, we better be going.
Wait, can I borrow your handkerchief?
What handkerchief?
Some people say my act is pretty foul.
Cardamon the Great?
I bet you can't guess what the test is about.
Out of the fire.
Astronomy.
No, you'll never guess.
Thank you.
sensitivity.
Sensitivity? Did you hear? Cardamom the Great.
Cardamom the Greatest. Now, let me tell you the rest.
But may I ask one favor? May I have this?
What do you want with that?
A memento because of my father.
Take it!
Thank you, ma'am!
Jester!
Thank you, ma'am!
That was a wonderful thing you did for that girl, Cardamon.
Well, for her father's sake.
Say. We won't have to get out of here until daybreak. Why don't we all go down to the wine cellar and split a bottle and talk some more about... talk some more.
Fine, fine. But first, let me finish something I've been working on here. I'll be with you in 2 seconds.
We'll be waiting.
What's the matter, Jester?
Oh, nothing.
Say something funny.
Have you ever heard of my father, Sliding Peter Jingle?
Is that funny?
I don't know.
I think the clown is losing her touch.
I'm far from sentimental or romantic. And I like to think I'm strictly up to date. But at times the dancing gets a bit too frantic in these hectic days of 1428. So indulge me if I pause to raise my chalice to a quaint and charming dance they used to do in the days when my dear father played the palace. My dad was debonair and quite as light as air. In his very soft shoes, how he could dip and glide and skip and slip and slide. In his very soft shoes, I used to stand and watch him every day. He was always smooth and I used to love to hear the people say he's a regular dancing fool. He barely touched the ground and never made a sound, but I noticed in all his reviews that when he took his bow to the crowd and the crowd went crazy and the house came down. My daddy wore his very soft shoes.
Thank you.
goes there, friend? Oh.
Friend?
Oh.
Oh, Harry, I hope you know that I didn't mean to... Harry? Harry, look at me! Yes, I was going to run away, but I thought it was only because you didn't love me! Even if you don't love me, I can never love anyone but you, and I want to be around you for as long as possible! If possible! Oh, Harry, don't blame me if you've changed.
Well, in a way I have. Yesterday I loved you as never before. So please don't think me strange. I've undergone a change. For today I love you even more. My heart cannot be trusted. I give I openly confess, tonight I love you less than I will tomorrow.
Yesterday I loved you as never before, but that was long ago, and now it's best you know that today I love you.
As anyone ever could be. Now I see what tricks my eyes can play. Yesterday I must have been out of my mind, or else I was utterly blind, for I find you so much lovelier today.
Today my heart cannot be trusted. I give you fair warning.
Drowsy into sweet aroma wraps us
in a gentle coma. Murmuring voices seem to say, Mr. Sandman's on his way. And the potion? An extract of opium and warm milk before going to bed, I always say. Now, drink it down. That'll get us to sleep, shouldn't it? The sleeping draft. Now, why aren't you in bed yet?
Oh. I'm almost there.
Oh, God. Help her up. Is she okay? What is she doing? Go help her. Go, go. Ready? Go. Oh. Anyways, to make sure you have no problem drifting off, we prepared a very special treat for you. Bring on the nightingales of Samarkand. Well, who has the nightingales of Samarkand? Naturally, I have to do everything myself! All right. Now, sing! Stop! You were brought here to put a live princess to sleep, not to wake up a dead one. Now let's have a lullaby, Bertie. Nice and soft. Yeah. Fair enough. Well, at least one person's going to get a good night's sleep. Sensitivity, seeing that pee would keep a real princess awake.
And she slept?
Oh, darling, I'm sure I don't know, but she was practically falling asleep before her head hit the pillow. And yawning like a vulgar scullery maid. I mean, she looked ghastly, darling, tired and old enough to be your... Never mind.
Fred!
secretly dying.
Yourself,
Phil.
Be here in a moment.
If she didn't pass, I just might go crazy.
Quiet, here comes the queen.
Genuine princess, one that so suits both you and me. So don't worry. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Your Majesty.
All up bright and early to see the princess off. Well, since she's such a favorite of ours, we have a very special consolation prize for her, Sir Studley.
A very thoughtful gift, Your Majesty.
Indeed. Doubtless. Well, where is our little slugbed? She should be upright in a... Oh, why look, she isn't even dressed yet. 37,428 what? Sheep.
What do you stuff your mattresses with? Jousting equipment?
You didn't sleep?
I never shut my eyes.
Hey, you passed! Oh, my God. The test, all over the Peter toy mattresses, and you slept, and now we can get married!
Pee under 20 mattresses? No wonder I'm black and blue!
Don't you think she's pretty now?
Oh, she's not pretty. She's beautiful!
And pee under 20 mattresses?
Dauntless, I'll leave the wedding arrangements up to you. I'd start looking for a small kingdom for us. I have a feeling we're not going to want to live with the in-laws.
She's going to get cold sleeping on the ground like that. I better check up to her room.
Dauntless, wait!
What should I wait for, Mama?
To give this matter proper consideration.
The proper consideration is you pass the test.
Now you listen to your mother. From this heartbreaking business. I have never nagged, never interfered, and never asked for one little word of sympathy.
Mama, she's
but I
sleeping.
Will not allow you to throw yourself away on this little nobody.
Mama, quiet.
I mean, she may have passed the test, but I won't. I've never trusted anyone with those beady eyes or that mean little.
I don't want to shut up.
It happened. The mouse devoured the hawk.
Look.
What?
I can talk.
The king can talk.
And I've got a lot to say. Well, good night. Unhand the boy. Go ahead. Now, Agravaine. You've asked for it, and now you've got it. When I say I want you to hop, I want you to hop. Hop! I said hop! Skip! Jump! Hop! Skip! Jump!
How did she stay away? That pee was awfully small.
But it wasn't the pee!
It wasn't the pee! It wasn't the pee at all! Oh, life is grand!